mindful meditation and its relationship to glaucoma, this is something very new in terms of research in relation to glaucoma. Recent studies have shown that lowers intraocular pressure, though that's one major way by which meditation can help glaucoma. And in that study in India, the amount of eye pressure lowering was about 4 millimeters of mercury. Now, take into account that that's with a very sort of intense mindfulness meditation of 1 hour per day in this controlled environment. So there was a very strict regimen here. And another other ways meditation can help glaucoma is that it can increase the factors that can be very positive or good for the optic nerve and protect against glaucoma. And it can help reduce the factors in the blood that may be damaging to the optic nerve. So in those similar studies, they had also looked at those blood factors. And so those were beneficial for glaucoma.
Do's and don'ts of glaucoma eye drops. One of the most important things when using the eye drops is to make sure that you use them. Compliance is the most important thing. The drops will only work as well as the patient uses them. So if they're multiple times a day or once a day, it's just important to make sure you get them at around the same time every day into the eye. Sometimes it can be difficult to put the drops into the eye and know that it's gotten in the eye. So I tell my patients to put the drop in the refrigerator so that the medication feels cool. When it touches the eye, then you're confident that it got into the eye. Another tip that I tell some of my patients is to lean forward and look in the mirror and pull your lower lid down. And sometimes you can visualize that little pocket down there and deposit the drop right into there. Some of the don'ts that are important to know about eye drops is that you have to be very careful with the tip of the drop. You want to make sure it doesn't come into contact with anything at all. The tip of the eyedropper has a hole in it, and it's a place where bacteria can get in and cause an infection, and you definitely don't want that going on your eye. The other thing is you don't want to use expired medication. The expiration date is specifically meant to show the integrity of the drug, how well it's going to work, and also show that the medication will stay infection-free and sterile for that amount of time. So if there's a medication past its expiration date, it's not a good idea to use it. Other than that, I think drops are an effective way to treat glaucoma.
A question that I get often is, will I lose my driver's license if I've been diagnosed with glaucoma? It's a great question. It's a scary question because we all don't want to lose something that creates independence for us, and driving is something that creates independence. The majority of the time, no, you will not lose your license if you're diagnosed with glaucoma. And that's really the key, diagnosing it at an early phase. And if you do get diagnosed with it, the majority of the time, you're still going to be able to see very well and pass all the different driver's license tests in the various states. Now, there are times where there is the potential, and that would be a situation if you have very advanced glaucoma, where a lot of your peripheral vision, unfortunately, has been lost. Certain states do have requirements in what you need to be able to see peripherally. And so you'll want to seek out that information from your particular state and your particular driver's license agency. But I will tell you that the majority of the time, the vast majority of the time, no, you will not lose your driver's license just because you've been diagnosed with glaucoma.